Anyone who thinks there are no second acts in life obviously never met musician and actor Stevie Van Zandt. Little Stevie, as he is often known, has had a second, a third, actually it's hard to say just how many acts he's had. And now he has a memoir too. NewsHour Weekend's Christopher Booker talked with Van Zandt about his career choices and success.
Stevie Van Zandt believes there are two types of people in the world, solo artists and band members.
I'm a band guy. I'm an ensemble guy. You know, I like bringing people together and finding the common ground. You know,
but to Van Zandt, band can mean different things. There's his role with Bruce Springsteen and the E Street Band, as well as Southside Johnny and the Asbury Jukes, and as a frontman in Little Steven and the Disciples of Soul. But then there are also his television roles. He was part of a criminal band in The Sopranos. As he recounts in his new memoir, Unrequited Infatuations, his shifting band guy story starts, not surprisingly, with rock and roll. It went like this. Born in Boston, raised in New Jersey, falls in love with music in the early 60s, gets a guitar, learns to play, and then the Beatles change things for him entirely. First on Ed Sullivan, and then with the release of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, opening his eyes to the artistic possibilities of a life in music. Van Zandt considering himself part of the third generation.
And then here we come, and we're like, we take it all for granted. Plus, it became a legitimate business in the 70s, you know? So we were really the luckiest generation, I think, in that sense.
He may have been among a lucky musical generation, but it still took a tremendous amount of work. The hustle and effort of his early days spent playing night after night in venues like New Jersey's Stone Pony are cemented in musical lore.
I'm kind of a late starter, you know? I didn't start really actively becoming an artist till my 30s. You know, I didn't become an actor till my 40s, you know what I mean? So everything was kind of delayed a couple of decades, you know?
So you don't consider those periods when you were young and in your 20s, you're playing all the time.
Right.
You don't consider that period to be an artistic period for you?
No, that's a craft period. You know, I think you're learning your craft or multiple crafts. You know, you're a guitar player, you're a singer, you're a band leader, you're an arranger. You're a producer, you know. These are all crafts.
Van Zandt worked for years on his craft, recording, playing, and touring some of Springsteen's seminal albums, Born to Run, Darkness on the Edge of Town, and The River. In 1982, Van Zandt released his first solo effort, and 2 years later, he left the E Street Band right before Born in the USA was released.
And was it a painful decision in hindsight?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. The most painful of my life, yeah. Yeah. You know, you do what you're compelled to do.
Born in the USA, which Van Zandt co-produced, went on to become a cultural phenomenon, selling 30 million copies worldwide. The ensuing tour was a stadium extravaganza.
Was it painful because of just how big things then got immediately after, or?
I couldn't even picture that level of success. You know, The River did 3 million, and I thought that's the most you could ever sell. You know, we're selling out arenas. What else do you need to do? No, it was leaving one of my best friend.
Van Zandt stayed plenty busy though, releasing his own politically charged solo music through the decade, while organizing an entirely new type of band. Artists United Against Apartheid urged musicians who had long performed at South Africa's casino resort Sun City to refuse to play there while apartheid stood and Nelson Mandela remained in jail.
That was my whole life at that point, so I was completely committed to it, you know?
While his efforts were applauded by critics and fellow musicians, his solo career failed to find a wider audience. And by the 90s, his career had slowed down. But toward the end of the decade, the phone rang with an offer to join yet another band.
And, you know, a guy calls up and says, you know, David Chase, and you want to be an actor, you know? Well, not really, but I got nothing better to do, you know?
For 7 seasons on what has been called one of the most groundbreaking television shows in history, Van Zandt played Silvio Dante, the best friend and consigliere to mob boss Tony Soprano. Along the way, he would also rejoin the E Street Band.
Was it liberating to write a book, to take stock and process all of these periods and look at it as one, to try to create one thing?
Really going back and living the moments chronologically helped me understand why I made some decisions, you know, that I've always wondered about, you know. I don't look back on anything I did artistically and think I wish I'd done something different or better. I really, really quite happy with my work when I went back and really re-examined it, you know? That's the thing. Jump in at 100%. Craft. It comes down to craft. The art takes care of itself.